Alright guys, before we get into the video, two things. First, my friends and I did this challenge called Fit February, where you had to eat super healthy, and if you didn't, then you got punished. I'm gonna put some pictures at the end of the video of me freshman year that I didn't get to put in the first video. So as I said in the previous video, I'm gonna be looking at the training I did, how that affected me, and the results that gave me, and then hopefully you guys can utilize that to run faster yourselves. So this part we're gonna be starting in my junior year. My training over the summer was a bit more sporadic than it had been before. That may have been a result of me taking it more seriously than I did in the years prior. I think I was trying to run around 50 miles on average, and I was running 6 days a week. Now, the main problem with this year was that we got a new coach. And this coach and my dad, who was the athletic director of the high school, didn't really see eye to eye. So my dad, having coached cross country previously, would coach me half the time, and this new coach would coach the other half of the time. Now, there's a lot of conflict between the two of them, and honestly, having two coaches was kind of detrimental to my training at the time. My dad and this new coach had different training philosophies that kind of clashed, and so I would do her workouts sometimes and then his workouts sometimes, and so I wasn't training with the team, I didn't really have anyone to train with, and it was just really not the best situation to be in. It kind of put me between a rock and a hard place. Looking back, I would have just done whatever the coach told me to do. Despite this kind of conflict, I felt that I was in really good shape, definitely a lot better shape than the year previous, just due to that volume increase in training. I probably increased my weekly mileage somewhere between 10 and 20 miles that year, and I can attribute that kind of to the fact that I thought I had a chance to win the state championship that year. It was kind of a lofty goal, but it definitely attributed to me working a lot harder than I had in years previous. So some of the new training that I would do under this new coach was, we kind of stuck with our 6x1K on the hilly loop that we would normally do, that we did with the coach before her. And then one kind of new thing that she added that we didn't really do a whole lot in my sophomore year was we would do 400 meter hill repeats. We would run down this dirt road to this massive hill, and we would do 6, 8, 10 by 400 on it. Yeah, we would just run 400 meters up and then jog 400 meters down. Wasn't a super complicated workout, but definitely prepared us for cross country. So as I said, I was feeling really fit going into the season, and it showed in the early part of the season. I got a huge PR of 16:06 at a race the year before I had run 17:20, and then 1 week later I backed that up by running 16:12. So I knew I was in really good shape. So that 16:06 that I ran, which was a huge PR for me, I was super stoked about it because I was only 4 seconds behind the guy who had won states the year before. He was returning, and it was his senior year, and being only 4 seconds behind him at that meet, I thought, wow, if I play my cards right at the state championships, I have a serious, serious shot to win this. But things don't always go as planned, and 5 weeks out from the state championship, I got my first pretty serious running-related injury. I don't really know exactly why it came about, but I got bursitis in my knee. It was actually really bad. Any sort of knee drive was incredibly painful, and I really just couldn't do it at all. So the only logical thing for me to do was to take some time off, which, at that point, 5 weeks out, I was not happy about. Because normally, about 5 weeks out, you're training just about your hardest. So I had to take 2 weeks completely off running. Couldn't even bike or really do any sort of cross training, which was unfortunate. But after the 2 weeks, running was bearable, but I knew that 3 weeks out, I was gonna have to start running again if I was gonna salvage anything out of that year of cross country. After 2 weeks off, I ended up winning the conference meet, go to the regional meet. The guy who was state champion the year before was in our region. He ended up beating me by over 25 seconds at that race. Honestly, kind of crushed my confidence. I knew I'd lost a good amount of fitness after that break, which wasn't ideal, but my goal of being state champion that year just kind of went out the window. So we get to the state championship, and my confidence is pretty low. The mistake I made in this race was letting the leaders go from the gun. I let him get too far ahead of me straight from the get-go, and I could really just never pull him back in. I think a mile into the race, I was in 10th or 12th place, which is just crazy if you're going to be the one trying to win. 10th or 12th place, and it wasn't a pack. I was probably 20 seconds behind the leader. So I made my move at the hill, passed a whole bunch of guys, and ended up getting third in the race, which was pretty good because I was only beaten by two guys that were seniors, which means that I was the top seed going into the next year. my senior year cross country, I was just a complete hothead. I'd run 70 miles 1 week and then get a minor injury and then run 30 miles the next. And so my training was totally inconsistent that summer. I actually still have my log from that summer so I can look back and see even workouts that I did and my weekly mileage. In terms of training, kind of continued doing similar stuff. In the summer, we would do those hill repeats. We would do the 1K reps. And then I started doing once a week the workouts that my dad had me doing my freshman year, the notorious 20 by 400. Except being the hothead that I was, I figured I did 20 by 400 as a freshman, so I need to step up my game. So in addition to running a lot faster in the reps than I did my freshman year, I decided I gotta do a lot more reps. So naturally, I started at 24 by 400. And then the next week, I did 26 by 400. And then the next week, I did 28. And the next week, 30. As I said, I was a total hothead. And then once I ended up doing 40 by 400 just to kind of see how it felt. It was more of like an experiment on my body than an actual workout. Obviously, I would not recommend these workouts to anyone. I was crazy. And actually, I had a teammate and a friend who did that with me. Shout out Caleb, you're a madman. When we get into the season, I'm feeling super fit. First race we ran was called Knight's Crossing. I wanted to run mid to high 15 minutes in this race, but I ended up getting like a major cramp and only running low 16s, which I was super bummed about. After this race, I didn't even ride back in the bus. I was so angry. I went with my parents and I told my dad to drop me off at the high school, and I ended up doing a workout after that race. I did 7 by 800. I think the times were pretty bad, obviously, because I just raced. I mean, that and the 40 by 400 gives you pretty good insight into just how crazy I was that year. So the next race after this was where the previous year I had run 16:06. I went from the gun, no one came with me, and ran 15:46, which was my PR in high school. A few weeks after that, we went to the Milestad Invite cross country race, where I ran 15:52 on a pancake flat course. That race, I actually lost my shoe 200 meters into the race, or maybe even less than that. But I know for a fact I could have run a lot faster, given better conditions, and obviously not losing my shoe. I won conference again, one region again, and we finally get to the race that I've been waiting for 4 years now. Probably even more than 4 years, honestly. The main guy that I was worried about had run low 16s, and then there was a couple guys right behind him that I was also kind of worried about. And I think both these guys actually run at VMI now, so shout out to them if they're watching the video. But anyways, we're on the line in the state championship. The gun goes off, and honestly, I felt in control from the start of that race. Everyone kind of looked to me to set the pace. I set the pace slow because it was super windy out, and I really didn't want to lead into the wind and just have people ride right behind me. So I think we came through the first mile in like 5:17, which is something stupid slow, right? And then whenever we would turn a corner and the wind would be at our back, I would take the lead and I would push the pace there and try to tire people out. Whenever we would have a headwind, I would try to tuck in behind people and just save as much energy as possible. But anyways, people are falling off the pace and we get to 2 miles and it's down to three of us. And as I've said before, right after the 2 mile mark is the massive hill. Make a strong move up the first part of the hill, drop the first guy. I make a strong move up the second part of the hill, and the guy's still with me. And at this point, I'm like, oh shoot, because I know this guy has got a pretty strong kick. So I'm trying to figure out a way to gap this guy. And so I push over the crest of the hill, and he's still with me. But on the downhill, I open up my stride and I start to even push it more, because I know if I leave it too late, then there's a possibility that he's gonna beat me. So I push that downhill and I get a little bit of a gap. As soon as that gap forms, I keep pushing. Now this is only with about a K to go. In the video, you'll see I have a pretty big lead. I got that whole lead in only the span of about 800 meters. But yeah, looking back at that last mile, the last 1.1, I actually averaged 4:48 pace with the uphill. So I think I had a lot left going into that last mile. Ended up winning the race. The team won the race. That's my experience with high school cross country running. That's how I became state champion. That's how I went from 19 minutes to 15 minutes in the 5K in high school. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. If you did, leave a like, subscribe. If you want to hear about any of my other running experiences, such as college recruiting, college running, my time training in Kenya, any of those, feel free to leave a comment down below. Follow me on Instagram, DM me. But yeah, thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.